Joe's job today is to work as your master of ceremonies, and I'll be short and sweet. I did want to say that I called my old friend Paul Webb on the way over here. Paul used to be the basketball coach at Old Dominion University, and he once told me back in the day, he tried real hard to recruit our governor to play for him back in the day. I said, Paul, I'm going to see the governor. Give me some dirt. Give me some words of wisdom. What kind of athlete was he? Paul says, Joe, I got an appointment. Tell him hello. And off he went. Thanks, Paul. But this fantastic facility, PRINCO, where we are today, what a great story. All those years when I did Joe's job, I wish I was still doing it, and I might do it for social media, to get in here and see the development of this product right here in our city, in our country, is fantastic. And I will start right off by introducing to you the CEO of PRINCO USA, and that is Brent Dilley. Brent, come on up.
Thank you very much, Joe. It is an honor to be introduced by such an iconic news media personality.
In his own mind,
yes, thank you. All right, very exciting. I would like to thank everybody for joining us today for the PRINCO LLC ribbon cutting celebration. Thank you very much. Thank you. We'd like to thank Governor Glenn Youngkin and Norfolk Mayor Kenny Alexander for being with us today. It's exciting. Oh, thank you. It's exciting to see so many mayors, vice mayors, council members, and state legislators, as well as appointed officials from throughout the region. Congressman Bobby Scott and former Governor Bob McDonald were also kind enough to join us here today. We appreciate you all. Thank you. Thanks as well to my partners, Vitaly Servudis and Chris Dement, as well as our dedicated PRINCO team. We have managed to achieve this innovative partnership and this incredible 80,000 square foot manufacturing facility from inception to production in an unprecedented 77 days. I'd like to also recognize the Premier team as thought leaders in the healthcare industry, and I would especially like to thank Mr. Colin Bain, for without him, this factory would not be in existence today. I'd also like to thank my wife for supporting me in this process. It takes long days and long nights to start a factory like this, but her job is much harder than mine, being 8.5 months pregnant with our first child while also being a full-time social worker. Thank you, Amy. We are grateful that so many healthcare, assisted living, and service organizations are represented today. Thank you all for joining as we take another important step forward in securing your medical supply chains so that you can focus on what matters most, delivering the highest standard of care to your communities. So thanks to Governor Youngkin, Mayor Alexander, and their talented teams of industrial futurists, PRINCO has met that challenge and brought manufacturing from overseas back to the United States. Based right here in Norfolk, our state-of-the-art facility manufactures a range of high-quality incontinence products readily available to those in need. To your left is the first of four manufacturing machines that will be installed this year, and this factory will be capable of producing over 300 million pads per year, and starting next week, this facility will begin servicing more than 4,400 hospitals and healthcare providers nationwide. This exemplary PRINCO venture is a blueprint for future investments in Norfolk, Hampton Roads, the Commonwealth of Virginia, and the United States of America. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much. By the way, I see former Governor Bob McDonald is here. Governor, thank you for coming today. Next, I'll introduce the CEO of Premier, and that's Mike Alkier. Give him a good welcome here.
Mike, thank you. Thank you. And Brent, thanks for opening up with the great comments. Governor Youngkin, thank you for being here. Mayor Alexander, appreciate the time as well. So just a little bit about Premier and my background. So I grew up, the governor asked, where was I raised? I was raised in Akron, Ohio. I actually went to Firestone High School. So with a name like that, You know that I have a passion about trying to bring manufacturing back into this country. A big proponent of manufacturing domestically. At Premier, we represent more than 4,000 hospitals, and our hospitals are actually, they put their money where their mouth is. We have made investments in Texas to build out face masks. We've obviously are doing the incontinence work here. We've made investments doing generic drug manufacturing in North Carolina, partnerships in Texas again with gloves, and then we're building out an isolation gown manufacturing facility in Tennessee. The reason behind that is we were actually, as an industry, healthcare, we were caught flat-footed during the pandemic. And we actually unnecessarily exposed our caregivers to the virus, the pandemic, when we didn't have the kind of PPE that was necessary. We were way too dependent and way too reliant in Southeast Asia manufacturing and more in one country, in China. And organizations like this, partnerships like this, really help us to diversify that supply chain. So it's really important that we continue to make those investments. We love this place. Virginia is a great spot for commerce. We know there's a lot of investment happening here to bring jobs back into the state, and we couldn't be more proud to be part of this venture. Thanks for having us.
And now a man who needs no introduction, the longtime mayor of the city of Norfolk. Let's have a nice warm welcome for our mayor, Kenny Alexander. Mayor, it's all yours.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Joining former Governor McDonnell and Congressman Scott, I see Delegate Angela Louise Graves from the city of Norfolk, J.P. Page, and from Virginia Beach, my good friend, the mayor, Bobby Dyer. Also, the vice mayor of Hampton, Jimmy Gray, is here as well. Thank you all for being here. And from the city of Chesapeake, Don Carey is right there. Don, thank you for being here. This is regionalism. Truly, regionalism is at its best. Thank you, Governor Youngkin, for joining us today for this important announcement. We are pleased that Norfolk business-friendly environment, our transportation infrastructure, and our skilled workforce offer the right advantages for manufacturing of vital products for not only Hampton Roads, but for our nation. We appreciate the trust and our ability to help Premier and PRINCO boost their U.S. productivity and distribution. We look forward to growing our local economy and our state economy with you and building our workforce. Now it's my pleasure to introduce someone who needs no introduction, our governor, the 74th governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia, Glenn Youngkin.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, I so appreciate everybody recognizing how important a day like today is. Because a day like today is a celebration about innovation, a celebration about aspiration, and a celebration about opportunity. And here we are in a manufacturing footprint that, starting with one, will be four, and if we do a great job, we'll expand beyond here. That is innovation. I mean, Mr. Mayor, just 1 month ago, we were together at Advanced Integrated Technologies, opening up another example of aspiration and innovation. And it is so great to be back here again. Friends, this is happening all over the Commonwealth of Virginia. And it's exciting to watch Virginia shift into high gear, because we are there. And today is an exciting example of watching collaboration at the heart of that innovation bring home manufacturing, to bring manufacturing that was in Asia and specifically was in China back to the United States, back to Virginia. And I have said many times that I want Made in America to stand for Made in Virginia. That's what we're up to today. And I love the fact that We have leaders from all over Hampton Roads, business leaders, community leaders, elected leaders. Thank you all for coming together and recognizing this important moment. Mike, thank you for believing in Virginia. Brent, thank you for understanding how to deliver this kind of extraordinary manufacturing collaboration. Colin, I want to thank you for vision. This is an example of collaboration that we don't see every day. We see a joint venture that is formed to bring the best of the best. We see Premier with its relationships with 4,400 hospitals and other health system participants representing customers who need a dependable supply chain of critical and essential products. We see manufacturing expertise coming through Vario Labs and through Caretrust for supply chains and delivering their expert capabilities. And they come together in a groundbreaking joint venture that is going to deliver not just an enormous investment, $23.8 million when it runs its full course, but 284 jobs right here. Sometimes individuals or companies or government officials think that the best path forward is what I can do. And today reflects the truth that it is not what I can do, it's what we can do. And when we bring the best of the best together to deliver for customers, to deliver for Virginians, to deliver for the next generation of those who choose to make Virginia their home, we can accomplish anything together. PRINCO, thank you. Thank you for choosing Virginia. Thank you for choosing Norfolk. Premier, thank you for believing in what we're up to. And I finally want to thank the Virginia Economic Development Partnership for the extraordinary work and collaboration, the City of Norfolk, the Port of Virginia. Again, multiple entities recognizing that together we can help forge a new way of bringing manufacturing, critical manufacturing, to the shores of our great Commonwealth. You see, Hampton Roads is not just the first stop for so many people as they come to Virginia, but it truly is the first stop for so many as people see America, our Navy, our manufacturing, great institutions of higher learning. What happens in Hampton Roads is a template for the rest of the Commonwealth and the rest of the country. And since I grew up here, people accuse me of being biased. And I say, yes, I am. Because this is an extraordinary place to live and work and raise a family. And so, thank you, Mike. Thank you, Brett. And you will be proud of the work that happens in this factory with Virginians going to work every day to deliver on the Virginia promise. God bless you, and thank you all very much.
Ready? One, two, three. Yeah.